Professional basketball has been an institution that has been run the same way for quite some time, so with the way things are done, we rarely ever see things happening for the first time. This, however, all started to change last year when the G League began to accept young talent into their G League Ignite program as an alternative to going to college while also paying these athletes a salary before making it to the NBA, and that completely changed the game. Last year, Jalen Green blazed this path by being the first top prospect to sign and play with this program, and he went on to be drafted second overall by the Houston Rockets, which is a pretty strong endorsement to how successful and promising this program can be. For today's video, we'll once again be turning our attention to this program, and the focus is on 17-year-old Sterling Henderson, nicknamed Scoot, who is doing something we have literally never seen before, and making history in the basketball world. Today, we'll be discussing his journey so far, what makes him so special as a player, and why he very well may be the next big thing in the next generation of NBA stars. Before we start though, if you enjoyed the content, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel, as not only does it help out a ton, but also very much appreciated. Now with that being said, let's begin. The G League Ignite program got off to a flying start last year as Jalen Green was a top 2 pick, Jonathan Kuminga was a lottery pick, and Isaiah Todd got drafted from that group as well, showing that young players don't have to play in college to get exposure from NBA teams, and if they want to be paid for their performances, they don't have to play in foreign countries on their journey to the NBA either, as now there's an American option. This sparked even more top talent to sign onto the squad for this season, and now the current Ignite squad is being led by some of the best players that will be available in the 2022 NBA draft. This includes Jaden Hardy, who was ranked as ESPN's second best prospect in the class, Michael Foster, who was ranked as ESPN's ninth best prospect in the class, Fanbo Zhang, who was the top prospect coming out of China, and Dyson Daniels, who was the top prospect coming out of Australia. That's a pretty stacked group right there, and none of you should be surprised if you hear a couple of those names called early on in the lottery of the 2022 NBA draft, but the one guy arguably making more noise out on the floor for this Ignite team than all of them is a player a full year younger than all of them, being Scoot Henderson, who right now is 17 years old playing for the G League Ignite squad. You may be wondering how a 17-year-old even got to this point, because he should technically be a senior in high school right now, but Henderson is paving his own path in a way that's best suited to his goals. In his junior year of high school, he took on an extra-large workload through more classes, and graduated early with a 3.5 GPA, showing that the stereotype of athletes destined to go pro simply chalking school does not apply to him and that he's a bright young man. And because he graduated early, he met the requirements for the G League Ignite program that requires you to have your high school diploma. They offered him a contract worth $1 million, and quite frankly, that's an offer that once it was put on the table, became an easy choice, as making $1 million to play the game that you love in an atmosphere that will set you up perfectly to transition to the NBA game is far better than going the route of college, where you play for free and typically have to play within a college system more set on immediate results than player development. He was the number 7 prospect in ESPN's ranking of the top prospects in the class of 2022, but ever since these moves, he has been soaring on the radar of NBA scouts with a legit chance to be the top pick in the draft when he becomes eligible. When you're a young player rising through the ranks at this kind of rate, it's natural for established stars in the basketball world to take notice, but what isn't common is for them to go out of their way to praise these talents. For example, Jaylen Brown of the Boston Celtics has said that Henderson is, and I quote, the best 17-year-old he has ever seen, which, by the way, there have been some incredible 17-year-olds in recent history, including number one pick from the 2019 draft, Zion Williamson. Former NBA player Chuck Person has called him a generational player. Shaquille O'Neal is in constant contact with him, monitoring his play and sending him regular encouragement. Russell Westbrook, who Henderson has been compared to on several occasions as a player, has reached out to will him on. Basically, the NBA world seems to be starting to realize that this is the kid that's up next, and it's time more of the average basketball audience does the same. Now, to get into what actually makes Henderson so dangerous on the court, we'll start off with the fact that he's the youngest player to ever play in the G League. What you usually see from young guys in atmospheres playing against grown professional men who have far more experience is that they tend to try more to fit in than to stand out, and naturally, nerves can kick in, and you end up playing conservatively to not make a mistake. With Henderson, though, if you didn't know beforehand that he was the one making his history for a player so young, you would never guess in a million years that he's the least experienced one on the court, because he commands attention and tends to be the one leading away, playing with more confidence than anyone else. Henderson is averaging about 6 rebounds, 5 assists, and 18.5 points per game in the G League so far this year, being the team's leading scorer. He's 6'3", with a 6'9" wingspan, he's already strong and built to absorb contact around the basket, and defensively, he has all of the makings of a premier perimeter defender. What I love most about this in particular is that we so often see young players with ideal physical tools come in with raw skill sets that need development over time, but with Henderson, he has the physical tools and the skill set and production of a veteran. He is an explosive athlete and has been proving it in the G League this year, attacking the basket with force and dunking everything possible once he gets around the basket. His mid-range jumper has been on point, and while I admit his three-point shot does need some work, the fact that he's both a very good free throw shooter and mid-range shooter tells me that his ability to improve from three over time is promising, because those two things are typically good signs for that in this regard. I'm sure many of you who have been watching this channel for a while know this about me already, but I am always in favor of young players getting as much experience as possible playing against the best competition possible, and the fact that Henderson is getting that right now while also impressing to this degree is why I, amongst so many others, are starting to acknowledge him as one of the next greats of the game. He's been compared to players like Russell Westbrook and Derrick Rose, two MVP winners, and on the low end of comparisons, I can still see him being a Ja Morant type player, which, if Ja Morant is your quote-unquote realistic comparison, you know you're on the way to being one hell of a player. Unfortunately though, despite being so obviously ready to make the leap to the NBA game right now, the rules will not allow him to enter the draft until 2023. Despite outperforming Jaden Hardy, who is his teammate, predicted to be a top 5 selection in the 2022 draft, Henderson has to wait another year to hear his name called, and it might just be the final straw that makes the NBA rethink their eligibility rules. Finally, to wrap things up, I know it's very risky to prop somebody up as much as I have today, putting such lofty expectations on them and their future, but the reason I'm so confident in Scoot Henderson is because of the mentality that he approaches the game with. Kobe Bryant was his idol growing up, and like Kobe, Henderson is one of the hardest working 17-year-olds going. In an interview with Sports Illustrated, Henderson talked about Kobe and his approach to the game, and regarding the grind to the top, he said, "The grind is just special. You can't enjoy the end success. You got to enjoy the grind so you can get that success." He's already talented enough to dominate the pros, he's literally just getting started with so much more room to grow, and he has the perfect mentality to keep climbing higher and higher and improving. So even though he has another year before he can be drafted, he's definitely someone every basketball fan should be keeping their eyes on. And with that being said, that's all I have for you today. Make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below what you think about Scoot Henderson and his future in basketball. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.